Okay, welcome back to another short video, a review of an item that I bought just recently. Now, this is the Cplay2Air. Now, what on earth does this do, you might be asking yourselves? Well, this is to do with CarPlay. So my old car was a BMW 3 Series. I had a company car and that had wireless CarPlay. So everything's hunky-dory. You don't have to take your phone out of your pocket when you get in the car, and it wirelessly connects to CarPlay, and fantastic. Now, I've just bought a new car, a Hyundai Ioniq Electric, which you've probably heard about if you listen to the podcast, and that only has wired CarPlay. So I purchased this fairly recently. It took, 3 weeks to arrive, and it's finally here. So what I'm going to do today is just open the box and show you what's inside, and then go downstairs, get in the car, and without any prep is see whether this actually works, because there's been a lot of debate on the internet around whether this is a scam or not. There's a lot of people that can't get this thing to work, and I think it comes down to a number of things, and it is, I think the main thing seems to be what make of car you've got. So not every car that's got wired CarPlay can make use of this item. So anyway, let's make a start and see what's in the box. So as you can see, this is how it arrived, weirdly. Look, there's the track label. Now, I ordered this from China, but mysteriously it got posted from Birmingham on 48 hour delivery. So I don't know whether it's a VAT dodgeroo or something. Now, gladly I didn't have to pay any import duty, which was great. So the real price of this is about 129 euros. I found a 10% voucher by doing a bit of googling, and paid 114 euros, I think it was, for this, or 114 pounds, sorry. I'll put up all the details of the website and everything in front of you now, so you can see what I'm talking about. So let's have a quick look inside the box, see what it looks like and what comes with it. And then, like I said, we'll go downstairs and give it a go. There we go. So as you can see, all there is, there's a user manual. Looks fairly simple. English on one side, and looks like Chinese, if I could read it, on the other. So that's what I'll be following when I go down to the car a little bit later on. And then, as you can see in the box, basically a USB lead. So that plugs into the USB socket that you normally plug your phone into, your lightning cable. This is an iOS thing, by the way, only works on CarPlay. I think there might be an equivalent thing that works on Android, but I haven't seen one. And I haven't actually got to grips with the Android Auto bit in the car yet. But so you can say, it says Cplay2Air on there. Let's just peel off the plastic on both sides. And it's just basically a black box, isn't it? So what this pretends to do, I think, is it fools the car into thinking this is an actual phone. And you can see there's a USB socket on this side and a couple of lights. I think this is meant for firmware updates. And as far as I can gather, there's been quite a few of them to fix various bugs and problems. So that's it. There's nothing else in here, I don't think. So anyway, let's go downstairs and see what we can do with it. Okay, right. I'm in the car now. This is proving to be quite difficult to film, trying to hold a camera and the thing at the same time. So I'm going to give it a go. So I've pointed the camera down to the socket where the normal lightning cable would go, and if I plug my phone in into the system there, you can see it goes charge. Oh, turn that off, and CarPlay has initiated. So that's how it works normally. So I'm going to try now and attempt it with the car Cplay2Air gadget. Let's see how it works. So let's just unplug that for now. So let's take this out of here. So I haven't done this before. This is completely scripted. You know, all I've done is open the box, and I haven't even read the manual, to be honest. So here's the actual thing. You saw it earlier. Let's get it out. And this is supposed to plug in there and pretend it's a phone. So I'm going to film this bit first and then go to the screen, so hopefully you can see what it does. That's what the instructions say. So connect the dongle to the car head unit USB port. So that's this bit down here. And I hope the sound's coming through okay. I've done this on another iPhone, because obviously I need the other iPhone to plug in. So connect the USB dongle and turn on the iPhone Bluetooth. Right, okay, let's try that. Oh, that's the car. Now, is that the car or is that the, I don't know. Oh, that's clever. Let's have a look. So let's go Bluetooth. I presume I'll see what's up there. Yeah, look, Hyundai F7D2. So you don't tell them what car you've got, so it must be clever enough to know what car it's being plugged into. So I'm connecting with Bluetooth, hopefully. Got the instructions out again. I say you just pair to this. Pairing unsuccessful. Okay. Let's try again. Let's turn Bluetooth on and off, I think. That sometimes works. Let's have a look. Let's turn Bluetooth back on. Okay, let's here we go. I pressed search. Didn't tell you to do that, did it? Here we go. That's connected there. Search completed. Click to connect. That's saying it's unsuccessful there, but I think it's actually allow. So that's worked according to that. Use CarPlay. Okay, connecting. Now let me show you. I'm just going to press stop for a second and go onto the screen. Oh, so the phone is here. There you go. Use a Bluetooth connection. Waiting for, it's going to work, I think. I got to, for some reason, I had to click pair again on the phone. It says connecting. It says not connected here for a, let's just see what happens. Connect, as I say, connecting. Not connected. Okay, and the car's shouting at me now. So let me click that on the phone. Here we go. So if I click connect fail, although it says connect down here now. So what's happening now? Waiting for connecting. CarPlay. It's connected on the phone this time, so will this work? Seems okay, it's here, it's working. Phone's not plugged in. All you've got is a unit plugged in down there, and we have CarPlay. So I'm just going to put the phone down so you can see it's not connected, and just run through CarPlay and see whether it's actually any good. Right, so I press stop on the camera then for some reason. Still not connected. It's not a Swiss. Here we go. Right, so it's hard to do this when you're doing it from a camera. This is Google Maps. That works. Apple Music. That works. It's running quite... that's my phone. Click there. This is all right, this. iPlayer Radio. Does that still work? Is that still an app that works? No, they've turned that off, haven't they?
It's that stupid sounds thing they keep advertising. Okay, that's all here. I didn't pick that, honestly, it's not a favourite. This is working. The only problem, I think, was initially that... Oh, it's downloading, it's got a... Oh, there it is. Yeah, that's coming on. That works. Let's go back to... And don't forget, you've got this new dashboard mode now on... thing. It's got your signal strength look, battery strength, and all that. And let's go back to the apps. Got my calendar, settings, tune in. All the apps are there that I like. If I click that, that takes me back to the car menu. But I can just go back there to AirPlay, Apple Maps, phone, messages, now playing, calendar, my audio books. It's all there. It seems to work. So what I'm going to do now is, in the interest of just checking its reliability, is turn the car off and pretend this is being sitting in the car overnight, and then come back into the car. It's bloody raining. If you know, see, look at the rain. Is come back into the car and see how long it takes to connect and if it actually works at all. But this seems to be working okay. I mean,
and sadly, I just couldn't fit it all in.
It's all working here.
I also get to hear some unheard things as well.
Let's go back to Apple Music.
During the course of the show, I asked some of the interviewees what they thought made someone good with money.
Yeah, that works fine. Okay, let's do that. I'm just going to turn the phone off and then come back in the car. Right, I'm back in the car. Everything's off. Door's open. All the AV's off. The little widget thing's in its hole. And the phone's here on its home screen. I'm going to stick it into its Qi charger, although that won't come on because the car's not on yet. I'm just going to shut the door. So my seat moves into place. And let's just see what happens now when I switch the car on. Right, let's go on. It's gone straight into CarPlay. Let's just check it's working. Turn that off, I'm gonna get a strike, aren't I? Whatever that means. Never had. Didn't think I get enough listeners to get strikes. Well, that's working. Phone's there. Da, 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 da. Settings. Oh, let's switch that on. Yeah, that works. It's working. And it seems to be working quite well. I'm almost surprised. I shouldn't be, should I? But it seems to work. So there you go. That's the unit there. It's got a little blue light flashing. I presume it's supposed to do that. What does the instructions say? The Chinese ones. I don't know. Maybe it just takes that initial time to get going, then it's fine. Online upgrade instruction. Well, I'm not upgrading it if it's working. Doesn't say. Nothing else. Nothing else to do according to this. So, is that a success then? I presume it might be. I've got to go do the school run a bit later, so I'm going to give it a go from scratch again. And... Probably not filming it this time. Sorry about the dirty carpet down there. And we'll see how it goes. But yeah, so I'm scared to say, but it actually looks like it's working. So this is an honest review. As you can probably imagine from the commentary, I'm a bit stumped as well in that it actually works. Because I've read so many bad reviews on this thing. And I think it does vary from car to car. It's interesting, isn't it? When you go to that initial setup screen, it creates a Wi-Fi hotspot, whatever it's doing, called Hyundai something. So it must know this is what sort of car it's in. And I think that's what you update the unit for, to be honest. Brilliant. Okay. let's leave it there. So that's all from me at I Confess I'm a Geek. Follow me on Twitter at I Confess I'm a Geek, and email me at david@iconfessimageek.com. Bye for now.